sign up for Synchronicity University in November and choose your own tuition rate. Hello, fabulous friends, fans, and superstars. Welcome to your horoscope for the week of November 24, 2019. I am your astrologer, Nadiya Shah. Thank you for being here. What an amazing week it is. We have an active and fabulous sky playing out for us right now. And it is this sky that is starting out with this beautiful energy that I spoke of last week, Venus meeting Jupiter in the sky. And then things change up before they find an inspired stability. You add to this a truly healing new moon and Neptune direct. Well, there's just so much to talk about here as we enter the last full week of Jupiter moving through the sign of Sagittarius. So, as I said, late last week, early this week, depending on where you are on the planet, that is when we have the perfection of Jupiter meeting Venus in the sky. You can actually see this energy. If you go outside at sunset, look all the way west, no matter where you are on the planet, you will actually see these two planets close together. And it is so remarkable because so often as astrologers or students of astrology or just fans of astrology, it's one thing to talk about what it all means. It's another thing to see it and to understand what it is that the ancients must have felt as they were contemplating the deeper symbolic significance of what it was that they were gazing upon when they looked at the sky. So this is a truly beautiful and special meeting of these two planets happening right on top of what is known as the galactic center, a very strong point in the sky. It has been thought of, conceived of mythologically as the birthplace of the entire universe, of the entire cosmos. So you can imagine what powerful love there is in the air. But like energy does, energy changes, and another energy starts to step into the picture as we move into Sunday. And that is a very different energy. Mars standing across the sky from Uranus is about as different as it gets. Now, Mars, compared to the energy of Venus, right? These two energies have been understood, especially by the ancients, as standing in a kind of a contrast, if you will, representing very strong principles of masculine and feminine. Venus, of course, being a strong feminine principle and Mars being masculine. Now, that doesn't have to do with whether you're a man or a woman. This is about how we understand the complexity of who we are. And we all have a part of us that is initiating and a part of us that is more receptive. And that is what it really comes down to when we look at these energies. And in their own subtleties, they represent this very contrast of action and of allowing or of receiving. And so Venus and Jupiter together, this is very much about knowing and feeling and indulging even. But Mars right now is in the sign of Scorpio, and Mars really likes being here. This is where Mars is the ancient ruler and is able to bring out its very best of what we call the night aspect of Mars. And so this is the part of Mars that, other than being necessarily what we think of with Mars, which is this, you know, sort of aggressive principle, fighting for what matters to this planet in your chart, it is Mars that is also considered strategic and understands what effective action actually means. It connects to a deeper truth of self and an awareness of our own power, and acting from that place, truly understanding that that makes a person unstoppable. And so Mars in Scorpio is able to bring out these subtle aspects that sometimes get overlooked in modern astrology. Now, standing across Uranus, in contrast to Jupiter, though these two are very different energies. Jupiter is about hope and belief and expansion. Uranus is about truth. It is about cutting through hope and allowing things to change dramatically sometimes and in an instant sometimes. It's not about what you wish for necessarily. It's about whom it is you authentically are and being completely committed to it, regardless of the opinions, of the influences of others. And that is part of the power of Uranus, is that it is unabashedly willing to be an individual, willing to stand out, willing to be itself. But Uranus is also considered the god of thunder, right? There's an unpredictability factor here, and it likes things to be a surprise. It likes things to be different. Standing across Mars, well, this very electric energy becomes amplified. The very possibility of surprise becomes magnified that much more. And all of us, in at least one area of life, chances are things are going to feel like they're moving very quickly and very surprisingly and in surprising directions as well. Some people thrive in this type of environment, right? But others less so. Now, regardless of whether it is you feel like things are taking you by surprise and delight, or whether it is that things are taking you by surprise and it is leading to frustration, understand this. This energy transforms in the second half of the week. Uranus is only interested in truth. So what does come forward is honest at the very least. And in its own way, Mars is concerned with honesty as well. The core of what is really there is part of what Mars is interested in. And so yes, both of these planets are about truth in their own way. But it is in the second half of the week that we are going to reach an important moment as part of the larger Mercury retrograde season that we are still in. So if you have been watching me for the last few weeks, I've been telling you since mid-October, we have had Mercury shadow, and then the first 3 weeks of November, Mercury retrograde. And now as Mercury is direct, at the very end of next week, we'll officially end retrograde. The whole Mercury retrograde season will be over. But at least for now, and at least for the second half of this week, Mercury will begin to make its third and final exact connections with key power players, defining this Mercury retrograde season for a lot of us out there. Mercury will speak in supreme harmony with Neptune. I'll talk about that in just a moment, but that in and of itself is an energy of near miraculous turnarounds. And as we move late into the week, Mercury will speak in harmony with Saturn, bringing in a more stabilizing energy as well. Exactly what feels so uncertain, so erratic in the early part of the week is exactly what transforms in sometimes remarkable, sometimes truly healing ways, and lends itself to a greater sense of direction, a greater sense of stability, and a greater honesty about what is worth manifesting. You know, it's one thing to be addicted to chaos. Sometimes that happens. Some people, you may know one or two of them in your own life. It really can depend. But, you know, it happens that there are people for whom external chaos is addictive because it is a distraction from the internal chaos. And then there are those people who actually find calm within chaos. And there are some people who really thrive when things are changing and unpredictable, and some people who find it stressful. Now, regardless, whether it is you are having your moment of truth in an external circumstance or it's playing out among people that you know, whether it is that you are having your moment of truth much more personally, much more connected to what's been happening within you on a level of your soul or even on a level of your heart's desires. Now, regardless, it is that very moment that then gives way to a true sense of inspiration, a heightened perspective. But also remember, with this beautiful Mercury-Neptune trine, there's a sense of things changing and turning around in a way that leaves us feeling truly blessed, like we have been touched by perhaps even a miracle. So that is something to hold on to. And this really is Mercury retrograde season starting to wrap up, and it'll be good and done by the time we get to the end of next week. Now, coming back Tuesday, okay, let's talk about what's happening Tuesday. There is a new moon. This new moon is happening in the sign of Sagittarius. As I said earlier, and I'm going to say again, This is the last full week of Jupiter moving through the sign of Sagittarius, not to return for about 12 years from now. So this is the last burst of blessings, if you will, and we're going to have a new moon to help it along. This new moon will be speaking in supreme harmony with Chiron. I am so incredibly encouraged by this energy. All of us are going to have a new beginning of some kind or another, and as part of this new beginning, we are going to find ourselves healed in some way. If it is that we understand what we do in the world as being a healer of any kind, that can be a really broad umbrella, but if that's what we understand, well, it is going to be this very energy that allows us to bring forward the healer within, to have it bless other people, benefit other people, but of course, what you give to others, you give to yourself, and that will eventually lead to our own healing as well. The energy of Sagittarius is very expansive, right? Jupiter is the ruling planet of Sagittarius after all, and it's all about taking on some new adventure. Well, where is it that some wounds of your past have kept you from embracing some adventure that your soul is asking you to take, perhaps in at least one area of life? Well, it is going to be this new moon that invites us to not necessarily, it's not about overcoming. It's about learning from and appreciating how we are better for all of our experiences and to take on the adventure anyway. When it resonates within us, heart and soul and spirit, when we know it is an adventure that's right for us, that, you know, maybe it feels challenging, right? But there's a type of challenge that actually we know is good. Like we know we're ready for it. And then there are those types of challenges that tell us like, whoa, hold on a minute, right? Take a step back. This is the possibility of genuine change, of inner healing, and of embracing our full presence in the world by getting out there in the world. And that can be a challenge, but that's a challenge that enlivens, it inspires us, and it motivates us to keep moving forward. So all of us are taking up a truly inspired challenge in our own lives. Now, under the same sky, I told you I would talk about Neptune. Neptune is going forward under the same sky right in the middle of the week. And as Neptune moves forward in its home sign of Pisces, on the one hand, this makes Neptune very powerful as he connects with Mercury in supreme harmony, maximizing that energy of miracles and magic in the air. But at the same time, for a lot of people out there, chances are Neptune going forward is going to feel like a light has come on. Like all of a sudden they're seeing things differently. In an instant, they have a different appreciation. And for some, this can be quite stark. But for others, it's going to be like, you know, they're waking up, but it's a slow and easy wake up. You know how it is sometimes when you get up from a dream and it feels like really stark. And then sometimes you wake up and it feels really easy. And it feels like you're stepping from one world into another, but in a way that feels almost natural. So it could go either way for a lot of us out there. But regardless, remember, with Neptune going forward, it is the truth. You know, again, we've got this energy of truth this week, but it can be a truth that inspires us and a truth that unlocks big spiritual blessings. Finally, Venus this week is going to change signs, and this is special for a few reasons. Under the light of the new moon, right around Tuesday, is when Venus will move into the sign of Capricorn at the end of the week, speaking in supreme harmony with Uranus. Now that Venus-Uranus energy, I absolutely love. That energy to me is so inspiring, so motivating, so encouraging, but it's also like romantic surprises and it's luck and it's blessings. So wherever it is that you are planning to do something that really matters to you, something that's important, something where you want that little bit of extra luck on your side, well, you may want to wait until we get into the later days of the week. That's when we're tapping into this energy that much more. But there's another reason why this move of Venus matters, and that is because it's going to start to give us a little bit of a preview of what is coming up next week when Jupiter moves into this part of the sky. Remember, Venus is considered a lower benefic according to the ancients, which means that Venus is a blessing, but it is Jupiter that is the higher benefic. So Jupiter is the bigger blessings than Venus, but both are planets that bring blessings into our lives. Now, it is going to be Venus now that gives us just that little bit of a glimpse into what is coming up. It is going to be next week that Jupiter moves into the sign of Capricorn, and it is going to be mid-month that Jupiter speaks in supreme harmony with Uranus in a rare and very fortunate alliance. I feel like Venus is kind of setting the stage, right? You know how if you go to a wedding, or maybe people do this in other places as well, I don't know. But when you go to a wedding, first there's like flower girls, right? And they come and they put flowers on the pathway that eventually is going to be walked on. It's kind of like that with Venus stepping into Capricorn this week. She's throwing flower petals as she moves forward on this path for Jupiter. So as Jupiter steps in here, is able to immediately start blessing our lives in really big ways. Now, Jupiter special horoscopes are coming. I appreciate your patience so much to superstars and to everybody else out there, friends and fans. That is coming up this week. They are almost done, so be on the lookout for that. You'll see a video on YouTube as well. I hope you absolutely enjoy it. But yes, for now and in our own lives, you'll get a little glimpse with Venus. And that is something absolutely to look forward to. This can also be Venus starting to set the stage for maximizing those big blessings ahead. What I love about this week for us, well, look, there's so much here, isn't there? But I do love this move of Venus. I love this new moon as well. It's just such a big and glorious week. I mean, it's the kind of week that Jupiter would set up before he changes signs. It is the kind of week that Jupiter would want, this very busy, very active, but also one that touches on how much things can change with faith, with patience, how much it is that just being willing to talk about what it is that you may be going through can transform your circumstances, how understanding can bring compassion and connection. We are going to see examples of this in our own life, but we're also going to see it collectively as well. It is a remarkable week, a week of momentum and excitement and a genuine feeling that we are moving forward in the best possible sense. Well, thank you so much for watching. What do you love about this week? Let me know in the comments below. I love reading you guys. Please like, comment, subscribe, share, hit the bell, notifications, all of that. And if you want to know how all this wonderful stuff this week speaks to you and your sign, log on to nadiyashah.com. Sign up to be one of my superstars. Superstars get expanded, exclusive videoscopes each and every week, unlimited access to special horoscopes and more. All of this in the superstar space. I look forward to meeting you there. Now, a note for superstars as well. Thanks to Mars and Uranus, some of this can be technical issues that come out of nowhere. We're having a few technical issues with the website that have seemed to come out of nowhere for some superstars. And so please be sure to check your emails, because there is a special link. And I've put all the horoscopes, the superstar horoscopes, on another page. And so you can access that and have a look. And I hope that you absolutely enjoy it. You don't have to wait. You won't have to wait to get your superstar horoscopes. And I hope you absolutely love them. I do have a few big announcements this week. So one, of course, is next weekend is my second sale of the year. I only do two sales a year. Next weekend, for Cyber Monday and Black Friday, there are going to be some very big discounts offered on my website. And so if you've been waiting for that, so please do make sure you sign up to my newsletter so you know exactly what is being discounted when, because every day there's going to be a different discount. And I'm just so grateful for all the people who have so much excitement for what it is that I do. And I'm really, really happy that I can offer these discounts at times. So I hope that you absolutely enjoy them. Lots of big discounts are going to be taking place every single day. Lots of 50% discounts and even more. So please be sure to sign up to my newsletter and you can enjoy that. And also Synchronicity University, if you sign up in November, you get to choose your own tuition rate. That's been a lot of fun. It's certainly expanded how many people are able to enjoy astrology classes. For a lot of people, it's the first time they're taking astrology classes. And I also know for a lot of people, you've been with me, you are my students, and I appreciate each and every one of you so very much. And so we are going to have An amazing winter session coming up starting in January of 2020. Really lovely classes. One is going to be on Venus in the astrology chart. I really wanted to do a Venus class, so I'm happy to do it. We're going to have Pluto part two, looking at Pluto in transit and aspect. Jupiter part two, looking at Jupiter in transit and aspect. We're going to have a class on chart rulerships and another on lunar mansions. You can get detailed information on each of the classes and sign up for the super low choose your own tuition rate, as low as $5 a class. And of course, we have that bonus class at the end as well. So it's like 6 weeks of learning that we get to share together live, or you can catch the replay or the download. And there's a Facebook group. So there's just so much that is really amazing about the Synchronicity University learning experience. And links are in the description below. I look forward to meeting you in class. My new book, The Body and the Cosmos, my near and dear to my heart book, The Body and the Cosmos. Well, it is going to be published very, very soon. It is available for pre-order on Amazon right now. If you get the pre-order and you forward us the receipt, because there are a couple of hundred people who've already ordered the pre-order but have not forwarded the receipt. You gotta forward the receipt if you want a free gift from me, which is the audio downloads of the meditations that you find in this book. And so if you would like that, because this book has chapters on each and every sign and how it connects to us physically and spiritually, how each of us is connected to all of the cosmos and all of the signs. And so each section of the signs includes a meditation as well. So I actually recorded these meditations with music and everything. So yes, they're available for download on my website. You can purchase those downloads for $19.95 for the whole set, or you can get it for free if you pre-order the ebook on Amazon. The hard copy is also going to go on sale on December 9th as well. It's just that the hard copy is not available for pre-order. I'm sorry about that, but you can get the ebook and pre-order, and I hope that you absolutely love it so much. If you are somebody who got the advanced copy, one of the 300 people who did order the advanced copy, thank you so much. And please be sure to leave, because lots of people are telling me how much they love the book. Please be sure to leave your positive review on Amazon, on the Amazon page, and it is in the links in the description below. I have lots and lots of live events coming up this coming 2020. More dates are being added right now. So in January 11th, I will be in Fort Lauderdale, Florida. I will have a free event in the morning at 9:30, a book launch party. Thank you so much to the NCGR Group of South Florida for hosting that. I really do appreciate it so much. And so that's completely free to attend. I will try to bring cupcakes, and I will be signing books and taking selfies, and I might do a short presentation as well. But that is totally free to attend. If you choose to stick around, or maybe you actually want to come to the talk and the workshop, you'd be very welcome as well. And so with the NCGR group, I will be doing a talk on the 2020s from Earth to Air. And then I will do a workshop on past lives in the astrology chart. So we're going to have a lot of fun, a packed day and a very rewarding day together of learning. So whether you come for the free event, whether you come for one of the two learning events, or for both, you'd be very welcome. And I'm truly looking forward to meeting friends and fans in South Florida. Immediately afterwards, I am going to jump on a cruise, the very first cruise I've taken in my entire life. I have so much to learn. I'm like online and trying to figure out, watching YouTube videos, trying to understand what to expect, but I am really excited about it. And it is going to be an event on board called Love, Joy, Hope, and Transformation. And it is happening under the light of the Saturn and Pluto conjunction. So very powerful time of change. And you get to be with like-minded people if you choose to join us. People are still signing up. I appreciate the people who have been signed up for a year, the people who are like last minute signing up right now. I appreciate each and every one of you. Over 60 people have signed up so far. I am one of several world-class astrologers who are part of this event. So if you feel called to this experience to be with people like you and to have a lot of fun on a ship, apparently it's a whole lot of fun and there's so much going on, If you feel called to this, check out the links in the description below, and I look forward to meeting you on board. Other events coming up and new dates are being added as we speak, but just to give you a little bit of a heads up, last weekend of March, I'll be in Istanbul. The first weekend of April, I'll be in Bangkok, Thailand. And then in May, things are really kicking up in May, tons of events happening. I will be in Toronto in the middle of May, Memorial Day weekend. I'll be at the NORWAC conference in Seattle. And then immediately after that, for the last week of May, I will be in Las Vegas. I'm gonna be back in Vegas and really looking forward to that as well. In September, I'll be in Colorado. So lots and lots of events. And again, looking forward to meeting friends and fans in person in real time. Before I go, I do want to give a big shout out and thank you to Ka Gold Jewelry. They are giving away 30 pieces of jewelry to people in need. So people who maybe can't necessarily afford their sacred talismans and their sacred jewelry, they are doing a giveaway. The link is in the description below. Now, I absolutely love their jewelry. I was like a fan of their jewelry for a lot of years. And then they reached out to me and said, can we partner with you? And it was just so lovely. And so anyways, because some people were asking, what did I get from their site? They did give me a little bit of a discount because I am one of their affiliates. So yes, when you click on the link, I do get a small commission for that. And thank you. Thank you so much when you do that. So it is this very ring that actually these sigils on it are from the Picatrix. And the Picatrix is a book that I spoke about quite a bit in the astrological magic classes that I did online with Synchronicity University. They're available for download at synchronicityuniversity.com. But this is a book that on the one hand was very important in terms of my studies. It was one of my major academic papers that you can read on my website right now. I think it's just called The Picatrix, the academic paper that I wrote on this text. But also the connection I feel to this text, because I know that some of my ancestors, some of their practices and some of what is in that book, there's some connection there. So to me, it was just so deeply meaningful and spiritual to find this on their website. And it was something that I had wanted for a very long time. And then for it to come together, for them to actually send this out to me, all of it just meant so much. So thank you to Ka Gold Jewelry for this amazing ring that I absolutely love and has a lot of layers of spiritual significance to me. And so I hope that you'll go onto their website, whether you win something, whether you purchase something, I hope that you find something that you feel is deeply significant and meaningful to you there as well. I do have other big announcements coming up this week, so be on the lookout for that. And December 9 is going to be a really big day where I'm launching all kinds of new things as well. And so I look forward to staying in touch with you through this holiday season and continuing to be here to celebrate the sky and to celebrate our lives together. And thank you. Thank you again for watching. It'll be a great week. Enjoy.